Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the film Why Him? Get ready to laugh. There are several laughs throughout the movie. I'm decked out because actually at the press junket for Why Him? They had all sorts of holiday sweaters and holiday hats to wear because this film is set during the holidays, starring Bryan Cranston, James Franco, Keegan-Michael Key, Cedric the Entertainer, Megan Mullally. How do you go wrong?
Not to brag, but... Harkins.
The Flemings are in the house! Yes!
Oh, my God.
Well, looks like he works out quite a bit.
Steffi, get him up here!
Please.
What is the craziest, most outlandish thing you've done to impress someone? Because your guy in this pulls out all the stops.
I guess I just haven't been the most romantic guy.
I don't know.
Really?
I don't know. You know, I've written poems for people.
That's a big deal. Yeah. And you're a good writer.
Oh, thank you.
It's not like some, you know, roses are red, violets are blue thing.
No, I don't go that way.
Oh, that's what I write. That's, wow, judgment.
Well, apparently it worked.
Yeah.
Happily married. When you were dating, however, were the dads looking at their wives going, why him?
Oh, absolutely.
They were, you could tell?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. The dads will not like you because they know what you're doing. You think, oh, hi, Mr. Thompson. Hi, Mrs. Thompson. How are you? And it's like, you're lying to me. Yeah.
My wife's dad was definitely one of those guys that needed to, you know, to have to sit down and get an understanding of who I was and who I thought I was. But the moms were even worse. So, you know, Megan was really cool in this movie. She kind of got him and was more loving. My wife, you know, the mothers and the sisters, when you got to get women's approval, that's way harder than the dad's a lot of times.
I'm very excited for you to meet my boyfriend.
This is his house?
Are you sure this isn't an Apple store or something?
I've been very fortunate. I have not disliked any of my daughter's friends who have come by. I really haven't. But now it's different. It's not individual. One guy doesn't come to the door and knock on the door and, hi, where are you going? Be back by 12 or whatever. They come in clusters and they move in groups like this.
To distract you, probably.
Yeah, it's like, what's going on? Which, and I go, which one are you, Dad? It's like,
I am on the needles and pins. I need you to tell me how it went right now or I'm going to burst.
I sense some Christoph Waltz in your accent. Is that just me?
Oh, right.
Hey, you win.
Oscar.
You win best
and the
new
Oscar
question.
Goes to best, the
no, nobody has asked that question. I was absolutely trying to do that all the way. I was trying to do that. As much as he's like very uplifting in his voice. You know, it's all
it's crazy. He can improvise in that accent.
At our first table read, I remember the accent was all over the place, and Megs was just, I remember I started speaking, and you just went, no! She just went, no!
Meaning, yes.
Justine, will you set Ned an alarm for 6:30 a.m.?
You got it, Laird. Ned, an alarm's been set for you for 6:30 and La Mignana.
What? Who is that?
That's Justine. Yeah, she's like Siri, but awesome. I got that chick from The Big Bang Theory, Kaylee Cuoco, to do the voice. Jay, say hi.
Hey, Ned. Hey, Barb.
If you guys could have that, whose voice would you actually want to hear all day long?
Nick Offerman.
Megan Mullally.
Actually, I think I also would want every other word to be spoken by either Nick Offerman or Megan Mullally.
So kind of a mix.
Yes, because their timbres are so different.
Yeah,
it would just be
totally
lovely.
Wow, that'd be gorgeous. You're right.
Can you imagine? Yeah, if I couldn't have the Offerman Mullally package, I'd go James Earl Jones.
Right.
It's time for you to get up.
Probably Morgan Freeman.
Oh, good
just
answer.
Just common voice. You know?
Yes.
How about you?
I'm going to go with Roseanne Barr.
What?
I just want to be totally irritated every time it comes on. Turn that off! Oh, my God!
James Earl Jones? I don't know.
Ooh,
that's a good answer.
Yes. Yeah. I'd have some sexy voice like, I don't know, Dr. Ruth Westheimer, something like that.
Okay. That would almost scare me a little bit to have Dr. Ruth in my
It's time to get out!
Welcome to the home of Laird Mayhew, the gaming guru of Silicon Valley. I am his estate manager, Gustav.
I feel like Laird's lair would actually be very similar to the kind of house you live in. what is your lair like?
It's similar, but it's more of a, it's more, because I got a wife there, so he was single,
right.
Kind of wild, so I have furniture and curtains and no buffalo roaming around. We have like Yorkies, which, you know, with the right glasses, can look like buffalo. They're very scary.
And after a few drinks.
After a few drinks, you're like, whoa, whose big dog is that?
That looks like a real dead moose.
Well, that's exactly what it is, Ned. A dead moose suspended in its own urine.
Your lair is filled with the moose and the urine and, you know, who knows what else. All kinds of crazy stuff. The most outlandish celebrity purchase for you?
Really art. I used to buy a lot of contemporary art.
Stuff like your character had? Because that was some crazy stuff.
No, I made a lot of that stuff.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Where is it now? Did anyone, somebody's got to have that in their house.
Those were replicas, so a lot of those are actually sold.
Really?
Yeah. They're
good
sold
for
in
you.
The museums already.
Are they really?
Yeah.
I am really impressed. That's pretty cool.
They're fun. Praise it's got me. A whole humping series. People
animal
humping, animals humping.
Animal humping.
It's a lot of humping.
A lot of humping going on. I'm guessing that's the
especially
case.
On Wednesday. You know why? It's hump day.
Ned, would you come join us? Okay.
What was the one scene, because you spent more time with the group, what was the one scene that really took a long time to get through?
I wasn't in this actual scene, but I remember being on set for it. It's the scene where Keegan and Bryan, like, Bryan's on the toilet and Keegan comes up.
Actually, we are a paperless household.
Focus on your end in there, and I will focus on your end out here.
Refreshing.
That scene took probably hours on end because Bryan just could not stop laughing. He was biting his tongue just on every take. It was so hard to just keep a straight face.
And I would imagine if you're like my husband, spending time on the toilet is a very private, you don't want to be bothered by anything or anybody.
Yes, no, that I couldn't even imagine someone having to be that close to the situation just so you can get up. You know, he was literally stuck there until this guy could figure out, like, this machinery. So, that is a very, very private moment. And, I mean, you're reading tweets, you're flipping through the gram. You know, once you take your phone in there, it's hours. You have to actually unnumb your buns.
That could be part of the toilet. They didn't have
that. They didn't think about that.
This
is new invention, so you'll see that on there. And he invented. We do now. Our company produces a new toilet, which we'll have the bun number.
Ta-da! I just got it done this morning.
Yeah.
Is that our Christmas card?
Gosh, it says Happy Holidays and everything.
What's the craziest tattoo you've ever seen?
Oh, I've seen some crazy. Well, from Breaking Bad, I've seen a lot of my image on guys' butts and things. It's weird to see that my face is planted on someone's butt.
Forever.
Forever!
You can't really question it either. It's not like...
And now it's like, hey, one guy had
can't
a...
Say, like, that looks terrible. Like, it's already there.
Yeah, it's like, hey, wow, there it is. There I am on your butt for the rest of your life. One guy had my face in there with Curly. Not Curly, with Mo and Larry.
Stop.
So I was taking the place of Curly.
On his
the
butt.
Bald on his butt. There was like Mo and Larry and me. And it was like... That was a decision made on intoxication. I was like, hey, you know what would be cool is if instead of Curly, I had Walter White on my butt.
But you would think after 2 minutes that decision would be quelched. Apparently not.
No, they stayed high for quite a while, apparently.
I can't leave without a song.
Why him? Why him? Why him? Because there's nobody else.
Okay!
Nice, Tara. Nice lip sync.
Because I've heard it for the past 30 minutes out there. It's catchy. You pick it up quick.
I think you might be insane.
I am.
I'm insanely in love with your daughter.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Why Him? Not all the laughs in the trailer, that's a good thing. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, giveaways, and we will see you at the movies. And one more message. Happy holidays, everybody.